Hello and welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we verify the whole setup, the whole side-to-side VPN setup between the Fortigate firewall in the headquarter to the Cisco ASA in the branch 2, as we named it earlier. So now let's go and connect to the firewall. And let's say again later and later. And remember that in order for the VPN to trigger, so to be established, we have to have interesting traffic in the tunnel. So we have to generate some traffic between the two remote private LANs. In this case, between 192.168.1.0 and between 192.168.3.0/24 for both of them. Now, also in the previous lecture, when I initiated an ICMP session, a ping from VPCS1, I was not wrong, but I was saying some other thing when I was pinging basically this LAN. I was saying that I was pinging the VPCS2, but anyway, I was pinging .1, so the inside IP on the branch Fortigate, which is not wrong, but anyway, you have to have connectivity between any IPs in the private LANs. So that's why the IPsec VPN triggered, and we have seen it in the upstate. Another option would be, so let's go to, if you don't want to ping, if you go to the IPsec tunnels, another option is to say right click, or not here, let's see, IPsec wizard, no, in the monitor one, so IPsec monitor, yeah, here it is, right click and say bring up. But before we do that, let's go in the log and report, and let's go to VPN events. And let's see if we can delete the everything we have here. So let's search for what? Download log. Do we have any clear log? So I don't see any clear log here. So disk, details if I want to see for a specific log. Okay, so we don't have any log, but we have a timestamp here, so 8:33. Good. So let's try now to initiate the VPN, and if it doesn't work, we will see what logs are generated here. So monitor, let's go to IPsec monitor, right click and say bring up. Good, so the VPN is up, which means that the configuration was applied correctly. Let's go on. As you can see, we have no incoming and no outgoing data, which means obviously no traffic, no VPN traffic is traversing this side-to-side tunnel. Now, if you go in the log and report and go again to VPN events, so it was 8:33. So starting from here, we have some logs generated by the Fortigate firewall. So date, timestamp, duration, local IP, received data. So something that it was generated by the firewall, so that the tunnel is triggered. Security. What else? Let's see. Negotiate. Progress. IPsec phase 2. Then IPsec SA. Install. So basically the parameters have been exchanged here, and because we have had a match. And I refer here to both phase 1 and phase 2. We have seen that IPsec connection status changed. It has changed, meaning that it changed to upstate. So it triggered two action here, tunnel up. So anyway, no necessary debugging here, no necessary. Most of us know the debugging process as a debug, but as you will see in the Fortigate world and Fortinet world in general, the debugging process is started with the diagnose command. But this is something we will do in the next section, where we will break the configuration and see what the logs look like, so that we get accustomed to what to do in order to fix the configuration when it's broken. So this is all for this section. Thanks a lot. See you in the upcoming section.